Hello people, I'm Sayyed Aamer. Welcome to a new video. In this video, we'll see the last version of the question related to prime number. As of now, we have discussed we'll be taking a number from the user, checking that number is prime or not, right? Into second part, we have seen printing all prime numbers between 1 to 100. Now, third type of it is we will be printing first 100 prime numbers, or the question can be first 100 prime numbers, for 50 prime numbers, first 1000 prime numbers, first n prime numbers. Fine. So here, if you see, if you're directly coming to this question, I request you to just watch my two previous videos, because to find if you're solving prime number question, so there can be a lot of ways to solve it, right? So please check how I have proceeded. Fine. Now see, I have the same program that I have written for printing all prime numbers between 2 to 100. Fine. So let's briefly see what we have done there. We have a for loop which is iterating from 2 to 100 because we have that range, and the value of flag was 0 inside it, and the value of I, whatever is the value of I, we were making the value of NO, right? And inside it, the calculation part was there of finding prime number, right? So in for this, we have starting from 2 going up to less than NO minus 1, right? And inside it, we have checked if the number is divisible by any value of J or not. And if it is divisible, we have made the value of flag as 1, and we have written what, a break statement. When it come out of this for loop, we have checked for it if the value of flag is still 0, means it didn't came inside this conditional statement. So we will declare that number is what, a prime number. That was the solution for printing prime numbers between 2 to 100. Fine. Now see, if you see the next question that we have is what, we have to print we have to print first 100 prime numbers. How to proceed with it? Before we start the solution, let me be very clear, there can be a new question also. Fine. So they won't be asking you big thing, or they won't be going with a rocket science question. You just have to stick to the basic and decode the thing that they have asked. Now if you come to this question, we were printing all prime numbers between 2 to 100, right? And if we iterate from 2 to 200, ho sakta hai, it's possible that we have printed all the 100 number that they have asked, right? But we need to be very specific. We have to print only 100 prime numbers. Who is responsible for printing prime numbers between 2 to 100 into this? That was this for loop, right? What I'm saying, if you iterate from 2 to 1000, what will happen? It will print all prime numbers between 2 to 1000, right? More specifically, if you see, this condition is very crucial for us. This condition is deciding till when you have to go, right? If you say 100, it will go till 100. If you say 1000, it will go till 1000. If you say 5000, it will go till 5000, print all prime numbers between 1 to 5000. Get it? Now see, if you change the condition, if you change this condition and made it for our question, like we have to print first 100 prime numbers, for it, you, if you use this condition, you have done the solution, you have find the solution. Now how should we proceed? See, what we have to focus on, our focus is on counting the prime numbers. Getting? Now see how we'll proceed. Once we find first prime number, that is 2, right? Okay, 2, we have found one prime number. Next is 3, we'll print 3 also, and we'll count that, we have counted this also, means we have found how many prime numbers as of now? 2. The next is what? 5. As soon as we get 5, the value of count will be 3. As soon as we get 7, the value of it will be 4. Likewise, every time you print a prime number, you will count that you have a new prime number, right? And you will iterate for how many times till your count value becomes 100. Getting what I am saying? So see, for that case, what I will be proceeding with, we will be taking a counter, the name of it, I will be taking it as prime. and its value is what? 1 I am taking. Fine. Now we are initializing it by 1. Fine. And every time into the code, if you see where we are finding that a number is a prime number, if it went inside this if, we are printing that that's a prime number, and inside this I will just simply increment the value of prime by 1. Getting what I'm saying? I will simply increment the value of prime by 1. No, and the condition that we need to take is prime is less than or equal to 100. Now see this condition carefully. Student asked me, sir, we are going with I, so how can we take prime? The condition can be anything. It's not compulsory that if you're using I here into initialization and update, you have to go with I only. Condition can be anything. You can use any variable into it. Fine. I'm using what? Prime here. Now see why we are using prime. And student asked me one more question, sir, why we are initializing prime equals to 1? Why not 0? See, I'm working on prime for iterating my loop. Agree? So if I want to iterate a loop for 5 times, I will start from 1, will go up to less than equal to 5. Agree? It will iterate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many times I want to iterate? I want to iterate from 1 to 100. That's why I am initializing prime equals to 1. And here the condition is what? Prime is less than equal to 100. Now student asked me one more question, sir. With I equals to 2, can we initialize prime equals to 1? That is also fine. You can go with that also. You can initialize more than one variable here. So here you can simply write prime equals to 1 comma I equals to 2 semicolon, likewise. Fine. So I'm writing it here. If you write it here or write it here, one and the same. Fine. Okay, so let's see how things will be working. For the first case, what will happen? I equals to 2 will happen. It will go inside flag equals to 0. Fine. And it will calculate for 2. 2 is less than 2, yes, condition is sad, 2 is less than 2, condition is false, it will come out of the loop. The value of flag is 0, 0 equals to 0, yes, it will print the first prime number, that is 2, and it will count. Prime will be incremented by 1, it was 1, now it will become what? 2. Agree with this? This will go back again, the value of flag will be 3, 3 is less than equal to 100, yes, condition is satisfied, it will, what's the value of prime? Prime is 2. 2 is less than equal to 100. Yes, condition is satisfied. It will go inside again. The value of flag will be set to 0. It will check the condition. 2 is less than 3. Condition satisfied. It will go inside. We'll check. 3 mod 2 equal to 0. No. Right. It will go back again. The value of j becomes 3. 3 is less than 3. Condition false. It will go back into this if. What's the value of flag? 0. 0 equal to 0. Yes. It will go inside, print the next prime number, that is 3. It will print 2, it will print 3. We have found one new prime number, right? So we will increment the value of prime by 1 again. Now see for 4, how things will be working for 4. What is the value of prime right now? 3. 3 is less than or equal to 100, yes, it will come inside. Flag is equals to 0. What is the value of 5? 4. 4, it will be what is the next new value of NO? 4. Now see. 2 is less than 4, yes, condition satisfied, it will go inside. 4 mod 2 equal to 0, yes, it will go inside, make the value of flag as 1. It will break out of this if and for, it will go here. It will check the condition, what is the value of flag? 1. 1 equal to 0, no, it won't go inside, it won't print 4, it won't increment the value of prime also. So the value of prime will be 3, it won't get incremented for 4. Agree? It will come back. Now when the value of prime will be incremented, when you find a new prime number. For 5 it will increment, for 6 it won't increment, for 7 it will increment, for 8, 9, 10 it won't increment, for 11 it will increment. Likewise, whenever you find a prime number, it will increment. And once you reach the value of prime to 100, it will go inside, print the 100th prime number. Getting? As soon as the value of prime becomes 101 is less than equal to 100, condition false, it will come out of this for directly. Getting? If question says, we have done this part, okay? If question says print all first 1000 prime numbers, so how things will be working? I equals to 2, prime is less than equal to 1000, that's it. If question says print first n prime numbers, so how will be taking? You will be taking a number. We have taken NO, so go with some other variable. Go with N or num. I'm going with num. NUM I'm using. See, here the things will be what? prime is less than equal to num. Take that num value from the user and take prime is less than equal to num. Getting this question, solution. Fine. So the same thing can be done for Armstrong number also. Again, I request you. So solve the same thing for Armstrong. Print first 100 Armstrong numbers using the same concept. Fine. The condition that you have applied for Armstrong number will be exactly same, and you will put this into for. Every time you find an Armstrong number, print increment the value of prime by 1. If here we have taken prime, right? Take some other variable name. Fine. So that was all about for and while loop. Into next lecture, we'll start with patterns. Fine. Okay. Thank you.